and welcoming you all to the video. I hope you guys are doing great. Are you also someone who's running or planning a small business? Then you must be aware of the challenges of running a business with very limited availability of funds. I think we all do. And every time we think of a new idea, we have something to start off, we just, you know, end up the idea because we do not have enough funds. In such a scenario, one can benefit substantially if there is the easily availability of subsidies, loans and incentives. What if I tell you that it can be available by a single registration? Yes. Yes, you heard it exactly right. MSME registration brings such benefits for small businesses. Let me tell you in detail what exactly is MSMEs. MSMEs are considered one of the highly flourishing and emerging sectors in India. They play a significant role in the industrialization of the rural as well as backward areas. In addition to this, this sector has opened the doors of job opportunities for our youth particularly. MSME and SSI registration is mandatory for small business entities. It will help them avail subsidies, concessional rate loans, incentives, as well as other registration benefits extended by the government. The eligibility criteria to obtain the MSME Udyam or Udyog Aadhar registration certificate differ on the basis of investment in plant or machinery. Let's understand, if you are one of these, what is the eligibility criteria for this registration in India. In order to become eligible for acquiring MSME registration, the owner of the business is required to invest less than rupees 20 crores and should have a turnover of less than rupees 100 crores as per the amendment on 13th May 2020 in plant machinery, either for a manufacturing or a service sector. If these industries exceed the investment limit at any point in time, they are required to surrender or cancel their MSME registration provided under the MSMED Act. Now, who can apply for registration under MSME Act? Anyone who can fulfill either one or other criteria mentioned below are eligible to apply for registration under MSME Act. You are a sole proprietor who have a private limited company, you have a limited liability partnership, and you have cooperative societies. You are a part of Hindu undivided family. You own a production company, that with the production of materials. You are an owner of one person company. If you are, then you are eligible. Let's understand what exactly goes into the procedure. The steps involved in the process for obtaining the MSME registration are right here in front of you. In the very first and foremost step, the applicant is required to fill the application form with all the required details. After that, the applicant is required to submit the form to the concerned MSME department. Once that is done, the next step would be that applicant is required to prepare all the documents needed for obtaining the MSME registration. Such documents should be in accordance to MSME registration application form. And usually this process takes about 2 to 3 working days to reach the next step. Once you are done with that, the third step is that the applicant is required to upload all the needed documents and submit the application to the MSME registrar. Then the regulatory authorities will process and verify the authenticity and genuineness of a document in the next 2 working days. After the successful verification of all the documents submitted, the regulatory authorities will issue the certificate of incorporation to the company. If you have understood the process clearly, let's move on and understand what are the documents required so that when you sit down to fill the application, you have everything handy with you. The documents that are needed are right here as follows. The very first is PAN card details of the proprietor or all the directors or all the partners. You need proof of ownership of the place being used as a registered office, such as allotment letter, lease agreement or possession letter, or a property tax receipt. If in the case the place is being used is a rented premise, then the rent agreement with no objection certificate from the landlord together with the utility bill. You need Aadhaar card details of the proprietor or all the directors or all the partners. You need a copy of Memorandum of Association, that is the MOA, and Articles of Association, that's AOA, and Certificate of Incorporation, that's COI, in the case of private limited company, together with the board's resolution passes authorizing the director to sign the application. You also need a copy of purchase bill of every raw material that you are purchasing, copy of the sale bills for end each product, copy of the industrial license as required under the Industrial Development Regulation Act 1951. You would also require an affidavit on Rs. 10 non-judicial stamp paper duly that is attested by the notary office declaring the power requirement and the status of the machinery installed. Purchase bill of the machinery installed will be required. A copy of partnership deed in case of the partnership firm. You would require a bank account statement. Bills that are related to purchasing and installation of plant and machinery. Now, who has the power to issue MSME registration and certificate? Important to know, right? Every state has its own separate department to deal with the process of obtaining MSME registration. DIC, that is District Industry Center, is responsible for this registration. Now, DSIC department is the right body to issue the MSME certificate along with the MSME number. And are you also someone who's looking for MSME registration consultancy services? If yes, you are perfectly at the right place. We are providing the best consultancy services for MSME registration all over India at very affordable rates. So right here, contact us if you need any help or if you have any queries. I hope to see you soon. Keep watching and keep learning. Take care. Bye-bye.